Greetings to you all, my people, and welcome to another episode of Damole News. All right, my people, we all know that terrorism in Nigeria is a business for some of our leaders in this country, just like Nnamdi Kanu said yesterday.
And I suspect that some people in government are complicit. They are making money with insecurity.
That's correct.
They are making money with it.
Now, we all know that anything that relates to the federal government, there's always a piece of corruption in it. So today, the federal government has identified 15 people who sponsored terrorism in Nigeria. But here is where the corruption comes in. Out of the 15 people, the names of the people that was mentioned was not up to 5. Can you imagine that? Alright, I'm going to be giving you guys the full details of this news, but before then, please help us like and share this video so that YouTube and Facebook can recommend it to more people. Thank you. Now, the news here reads, the federal government says it has uncovered the identity of 50 entities, including 9 individuals, and 6 Bureau de Change operators and firms allegedly involved in terrorism financing. Details of the development were revealed by the Nigerian Financial Intelligence Unit in an email sent to our correspondent on Tuesday night, entitled Designation of Individuals and Entities for March 18, 2024. The document revealed that Nigeria Sanctions Committee met on March 18, 2024, where specific individuals and entities were recommended for sanction following their involvement in terrorism financing. The Honorable Attorney General of the Federation, with the approval of the President, has thereupon designated the following individuals and entities to be listed on the Nigeria Sanction List. The document read in part, among the individuals named in the document was a Kaduna-based publisher, Toku Mamo, who is currently being tried by the federal government for allegedly aiding the terrorists who attacked the Abuja-Kaduna train in March 2022. According to the documents, Mamo participated in the financing of terrorism by receiving and delivering ransom payments over the sum of $200,000 in support of the ISWAP terrorists for the release of hostages of the Abuja-Kaduna train attack. The document said, one of the individuals is the suspected attacker of the St. Francis Catholic Church, Owo, Ondo State on June 5, 2022 and the Koji Correctional Center, Abuja on July 5, 2022. Another was described as a member of the terrorist group Ansarul Muslimina fi Biladi Sudan. The group is associated with Al-Qaeda in the Islamic Maghreb. The subject was trained and served under Mukhtar Bemuta, aka 1IAT, led by Al-Murabtun Katibat of AQIM in Algeria and Mali. The NFIU said the individual specializes in designing terrorist clandestine communication code and is also improvised explosive device expert. The subject was a gatekeeper to Ansarul leader Mohammed Usman, aka Khalid al-Bamawi. Equally, he was a carrier and travel guard to AQIM Katibat in the desert of Algeria and Mali. He is also into carpentry. Subject fled Koji Correctional Center on July 5, 2022. He is currently at large. Ananda was identified as a senior commander of the Islamic State of West African Province, Okeni. The agency said, the individual came into limelight in 2012 as North Central Wing of Boko Haram. The group is suspected of the attacks carried out around Federal Capital Territory and the Southwest Geographical Zone, including the June 5, 2022 attack on St. Francis Catholic Church, Owo, Ondo State. Ananda was described as a financial carrier to ISWAP Okeni. She is responsible for the disbursement of funds to the widows and wives of the terrorist fighters of the group. She was also said to have received a sum of 189 million naira between 2016 and 2018. The same person is said to own entities and business reported in the UAE court judgment as facilitating the transfer of terrorist funds from Dubai to Nigeria. Another individual was said to have received a total of 57 million naira from between 2014 and 2017. Another was said to have had a total inflow of 61.4 billion naira and a total outflow of 51.7 billion naira from his account. The document further revealed that in accordance with Section 54 of the Terrorism Act 2022, institutions and individuals are required to immediately identify and freeze without prior notice all funds, assets, and any other economic resources belonging to the designated person and entities in your possession and report them to the sanction committee. And also report to the sanction committee any asset frozen or actions taken in compliance with the prohibition requirements. And also immediately file a suspicious transaction report to the NFIU for further analysis on the financial activities of such an individual or entity. And also report as a suspicious transactions report to the NFIU all cases of name matching in financial transactions prior to or after receipt of the list. It said, the freezing obligation required above shall extend to all funds or other assets that are owned or controlled by the designated person and entities, and not only those that are tied to a particular act, plot, or threat of terrorism or terrorism financing. So, my people, that is it. As you can see here, the federal government has failed to mention anyone in Nigeria connected to this financing of terrorism, because there is no way these people that are mentioned here, there is no way these entities or these persons that are mentioned here can fund terrorism in Nigeria without having a source in this country. And secondly, the government has failed to mention the names of these entities that are involved in the financing of terrorism in Nigeria. So my question now is that, is the government scared or is the government also involved in this terrorism act? Because I don't see any reason why they are not revealing the names of these people, alright? Except the government is scared or the government is involved in this financing of terrorism. That is why they are not revealing the names of these people to us. You see, terrorism in Nigeria is a very lucrative business. Look at the money mentioned there anyway. 61 point something billion, 51 point something billion, 180 something million. That is to tell you that it is a lucrative business, alright? Let's even look at Gumi the other day, who was advocating for terrorists, or the Northern Elders, who was advocating for these terrorists. It's because they stand to gain a lot from it if the federal government decides to negotiate with these terrorists, alright? Because mentioning financial of terrorism in Nigeria without mentioning any Nigerian person sponsoring this terrorism is a scam alert, wallahi. The government are just playing balls. There is nothing they are going to do to these people. That's just the end of it. Because terrorism will keep on going in Nigeria because they don't want it to stop, because it's lucrative to a lot of political class in Nigeria here. So my people, that is it. A lot of Nigerians has reacted to this news, which I'll be taking some comments for you guys. And the first person here said, this is an outcome of intelligent officer and seriously security report that should not have been published before any actions are taken against these criminals. But be as it is fair, naming them publicly will affect any further action. And someone else replied him saying, you think the Nigeria authority will take any action against bandits and their sponsors? Once a victim is kidnapped, it should forget about being rescued. No action will be taken. So my people, that is the truth, alright? Even the politicians here in Nigeria that have been accused of stealing billions and billions and trillions of money, what have happened to them? So that is just the truth. Nothing is going to happen to these people. All these sponsors, all these criminals, nothing is going to happen to them. At the end, all this is just initial gagra, alright? Another person also commented saying, this is vague. I left what I was doing thinking I would see a list of the devils killing our country, but all I see are tissues of lies, nonsense. And the last comment here says, too much talk and less action. If you have found them, what else are you waiting for in punishing them? So my people, that is Nigeria for you. Anyways, I saw this news and I decided to share with you guys. But please let me know your opinion in the comment section. And please help us to like and share this video so that YouTube and Facebook can recommend it to more people. Thank you so much for your time and God bless you. Amen.